we're gonna go ahead and start the mission now.
Let me go ahead and say that the show just kept rolling as like it never ended. I was so impressed with the presentation the first time. That's what brought me into Samurai Jack, and they were able to keep that and still bring in the fresh new concepts and bring back all the voice actors who are living. Man, I really don't have any complaints about the episode, man.
I can totally agree with that.
No, I definitely concur. I thought it was awesome. Just the tone they brought you with, they kind of get you up to speed too. Like, it's been 50 years. I haven't aged at all. The time doesn't affect me anymore. And it kind of lets you know, like, where we're about to be headed in the series now that we finally return where we left off.
Not to mention, I'd say it's gotten a little darker while they were at it. I mean, some of that stuff is actually kind of messed up, yo.
So much stuff in his head, like, he's losing it, you know, because he's been pretty much by himself for 50 years and just thinking about all the stuff he has ever missed. I mean, you're bound to go insane when you think about it. Put yourself in his shoes.
Yeah.
He's having these flashbacks. It's like, it's not looking too good for Jack, you know? Things are looking a little rough for him, but I think...
He lost his sword, bro?
Yeah, he lost his sword. You know, he's doing what he can. He fights off Sammy Davis Jr., which is... it was a good episode. I liked it. It definitely was a nice way to get us back into Samurai Jack here.
Indeed. I'm kind of interested to see how the assassins thing comes out, because I'm actually feeling for those girls. But they're all right.
Yeah, I feel like one of them is the main one is going to be conflicted and possibly join Jack. Yeah, but do you guys think they're like clones of Jack? Like, who?
That's exactly what I thought. I think they are all ripped from his DNA.
Hmm.
That's what I think, because they have a stunning resemblance, and the way that they're fighting so well, so fast, I feel like they get a hold of Jack's DNA. And another thing, how are we going to see Aku in this? Because all they did was hint at him. You kind of hear his voice on the phone,
which I thought was hilarious.
Yeah, I thought that was great. But I just, RIP to Mako too, who was doing his voice. Yeah. He also was the narrator of Conan the Barbarian. I just, that was my dude, man. I was a big fan of his, so RIP to him. So I want to know, hopefully whoever they got to replace him, I'm sure is going to do a good job. And when they bring Aku back into it, I look forward to it. But I also like everything new that they established in this episode.
So what do you guys think about the future? Do you think he's gonna find his way back? Because I mean, that was kind of the whole premise, you know. Everybody was kind of like, well, how come he never made it back in time, back to his time he came from originally? Do you think that's kind of what they're gonna do? Do you think, and if they do decide to get him back, do you think it's gonna be after the season? Do you think they're gonna try to do some fan service and give us at least a few more seasons before he makes it back? Or
I don't want it to end like that. Episode went by so fast, y'all, you wouldn't believe it.
Yeah,
for me it was just like
22 minutes.
And it was great to hear the music at the end too. I mean, I knew it was gonna be back, but still good to hear that. What's that?
Good.
And they still, like, I even liked at the beginning how they're still bringing in different groups of like races and stuff in it. Like those girls, like those blue little girls, and how they had the antennas on their head, and that's how you could see them communicating. Like, the words that they were saying would visibly come out of the antennas, and you could see what they were saying. You know, I was like, man, that's just so cool.
That was a nice touch.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're looking at 10 episodes.
Right on.
10 episodes of Samurai Jack Season 5.
Will it end good, you guys? Was the story going to end well?
It's on Adult Swim, so unfortunately I can't say yes or no.
I'm going to say yes. He's been through too much, man, for it not to end well.
I think they might just leave it up in the air. Just the way everything's been going, especially, you know, with the hype that's behind this right now, like they could just end it and just be like, all right, we're done with it, we don't care. But I mean, if the money's calling, they might leave it up in the air, so they might be able to come back for another season.
No idea. I don't think Kennedy would want to do another season after this. There's too many other things he wants to do.
Well, I'm definitely satisfied by, even if this is the last season, just closing out the story here, giving us at least this kind of fan service, you know. The music is awesome. I'm glad they stuck with the original music. The artwork is true to the original, but kind of the style of everything is kind of a different pace, a tad bit, which is dope. So I look forward to see what happens. I look forward to see like the ninjas, the girls too, the little clones. We called it here on Mission 3 first. They're clones. We will see.
That's right.
How are we feeling about this, the Samurai Jack season 5?
I look forward to seeing what else happens. I'm just as excited as when it first came on, they were able to capture the magic. And like I said, it's just a continuation. It's just going to keep rolling. And I mean, I look forward to seeing how he's going to get his samurai sword, because you know he's going to get it back as Samurai Jack, man. So I look forward to him getting that sword back, but I'm also, all the stuff he's been doing without it, like, it seems like he's doing A-okay without that sword for right now. We saw that suit, how they can, you know, shift and stuff, and they, you know, he's put up shields, you know, and then he had that motorcycle. I mean, this whole thing opens up. He's on that motorcycle. He's just running all, just running around everybody. And so, like I say, he's doing just fine without it. So can you imagine when he gets it? He's got all this experience under his belt now. I mean, he's not physically aging, but his mind and his combat prowess is just going to be off the hook. I mean, it already is. So now, when he gets his hands on Aku again, you better look out.
We'll see.
It's going down. Yeah, his skills have definitely increased. That motorcycle, I'm digging the motorcycle. That's going to make for some cool toys for everybody out there as well. Make sure you go and get those products, support your favorite creators. But hey, man, I definitely am excited. I can't wait for the next episode. The only thing I'm disappointed by is the length of the episodes. 22 minutes flies by, and, you know, there is an end in sight, unlike on Dragon Ball Super, so I'm kind of disappointed from that aspect. But, and from that, we are complete with Mission 1, Samurai Jack, Season 5, Episode 1. I can't wait to see how many episodes it takes for him to get that sword back, too. But let's go ahead and get into the second mission, guys. We're going to be talking about that Ultra Street Fighter 2, the final challenge.